Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add voice chat to your GDevelop multiplayer games. For this, I'll be making use of this 3D template, which I made a few videos earlier. I'll leave a link in the description. You can click on this card right here to check out that video. You can also make use of any GDevelop project where you have added multiplayer to it. Now for this, we're making use of an extension which I made. A link will be in the description of this video to download the extension. And if you find the extension useful, you can also leave a donation on the itch.io page. So in our project manager, we have the extension right here, voice call. So if you have this installed, you need to go to the scene where you open up the lobbies for players to join. So in my case, I have my lobby scene right here. So in our lobby event, at the beginning of scene, we're going to open up the game lobbies. Let's add a new event right here. Okay, so we're going to add a condition to check if the lobby has just started. Here we go. So if the lobby has just started, we need to make use of an action from this extension. So in here, other actions, voice call, and we're going to initialize the voice call. So in here, we're making use of a PHS server. So you need to get your host, your port, and your path. But for this, we're making use of the default PHS server. So let's go double quotes. Let's add a zero here. .phs.com, and for the port we make use of default, which is 443, and for the paths you can add a slash here, a forward slash, and here we go. Okay, so we could leave this empty, but there's one problem. It's only going to work over a local network, so your voice chat is not going to work over the internet. Now to fix this, we need to make use of a TON server. Now a TON server is a network relay service that assists in routing traffic between clients on the internet. Okay, so this should fix that and make your call work over the internet and also help in masking your IP address, which is something PHS leaks when connecting clients. So how do you get a TON server? So for this, I found a website which you can get a free TON server. It's called Express TON. So you can create an account and you should get a URL, username and password. Okay, so this is for the tutorial purpose, so you should get your own. So we're going to copy our TON server right here. And in here, you need to add some quotes and you need to add TON in small letter, TON. Let's add a colon and then paste your URL right here. Let's get our username, paste your in quotes. Let's paste our username and let's get your password. And in here, we're going to paste our password. Okay, so this is done. Now we need to add an action so players can join the call. So in here, let's add a condition. I'm going to check if the game is running. So lobby game is running, and if it's running, let's add an action, other actions, voice call, and we're going to join the voice call. So this has no parameter in it, and okay, so instead of changing to the scene game before joining the call, let's take our action right here. I'm going to cut this. Let's add it right here, and I'm going to add a wait action. So let's wait 1 second. Let's place this before our change to the game scene, and I'm going to delete this. Okay, so with this, we are done. If we try launching a preview, this is not going to work in the GDevelop preview, and this is because browsers have restriction when accessing certain features like WebRTC, which is what we're making use of, from localhost or non-secure HTTP origin. So this must be served over HTTPS. And for that, we can make use of the GDevelop web build. So let's go into share and GD games right here. So if I click on GD games and let's generate a link. So this should serve our game over a HTTPS server. Okay, so here we have our link. Let's copy this and in Chrome, I'm going to paste this and paste this. And in here, let's join lobby one here and join lobby one here. Okay, so a little warning ahead, there's going to be an echo. So I'm going to press ready here and ready here. And let's start the game. Okay, so we have our two players. We have our mic turned on right there. If it's your first time playing, you may need to grant permission to use your microphone. There we go. So since I'm currently recording a video, you cannot hear it, but I can switch to my other laptop. So here's a recording of me playing the game from two different laptops, which should serve as two different players. Okay, so here I have the game open on two different laptops. Here I'm going to press join, and in here I'm going to press join. We're going to press ready here and ready here. And if I start the game, I have these two laptops side by side, so it's going to echo. So start the game and we have this. Okay, so we have two players. As you can see right here, we have our microphone turned on, and in here it's asking for permission to use our microphone. So I'm going to go ahead and allow this. There you go, that's how to add voice chat to your GDevelop multiplayer games. If you found this tutorial useful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. I'll see you guys in my next tutorial.